Mentorship is a funny thing when it comes to fatherhood. If you're lucky, you have a dad or another father figure to emulate when the time comes to be a dad yourself. When you are a father with a physical disability, it may seem like no one else can possibly understand your concerns or trepidations. Rest assured, you can do this. Many of us wheelchair daddies are proof that it can be done. It is difficult to believe my kids are in their teens. Time goes by so fast, from diapers to dating. Like many fathers, life tends to be a whirlwind of have-tos and must-haves. Late nights at the office, bills to pay, marriages to maintain and nourish. Yet there are plenty of memories that are worth placing in the forefront of your brain. Those precious thoughts of holding your son for the first time, your daughter's first ballet recital, and being the ad hoc photographer at every major event in their lives. Most fathers have these thoughts in common, but in my case, there is a wheelchair present in every one of these memories. You see, being a wheelchair daddy is paradoxical. It is just the same as being any other dad, yet completely different. My kids rarely thought of me as a chair user, except for the times the world around them were ever too ready to remind them of this fact. There were moments when my kids were sheepish in introducing me to their school friends, or times that my son said he wished I could play soccer with him like other daddies. I won't lie, those moments stung, but they were the exception and not the rule. I remember how both my children were understanding and helpful, ever ready for the push up the hill or help off the floor from a bad transfer. My fatherly advice centered on familiar territory that resonates with most dads. Try your hardest. Never throw the first punch. Respect your mother. Look people in the eye when you're talking to them. However, due to the uniqueness of their dad being a chair user, some of our talks centered on the specificity of treating all people with respect and dignity, being aware of those different from ourselves, and our collective responsibility to assist others when there is a need. During these teenage years, there isn't a lot of talk about the origin of my disability. There are no in-depth discussions on those touch-and-go hours in the emergency room, the struggles of rehabilitation, or the years of perseverance to become as independent as I could be. Maybe chalk it up to these self-focused years of adolescence. But there will be a time when my hardships and lessons learned will come in handy during those difficult days that my kids will undoubtedly face growing up into adulthood. I will be there with words of encouragement, the same words that seem a bit cliche, but nonetheless true. Never give up. Appreciate what you have. Avoid focusing on what is missing, and find strength in yourself, but know that no one can do this all alone. I smile as I write this because those are the same words from my father as I was battling through rehabilitation 30 years ago. I guess the past truly is prologue. My advice to new wheelchair daddies is not to overthink it. Your kids will love you for who you are. It just so happens that your brand of fatherhood is conducted from a chair. Your life experiences, tough as they are or were, are blessings for your family. As your children grow, they will see these life lessons embodied in your actions and your love for life. Keep it rolling, wheelchair daddy. You'll do fine.